Hey guys, it's Mel here. Today, our friends at Invader PC have invited us to check out their up and coming showroom. And something about breaking a PC? I don't know. What are we waiting for? Let's go find out.
What's good, Mel?
Took you long enough.
What do you mean? I don't know what you're talking about.
What?
Hey, in any case, welcome to the Invader PC showroom. Hey Mel, thanks for taking the time to actually drop by.
Thank you for having me. Very excited to be here. But first and foremost, I heard we're going to break a PC.
I guess you could call it that, but hold that thought. We're actually here, right, to do something for AMD.
Okay.
So we're actually doing something for their AMD Threadripper Pro CPUs over here.
There.
And here. And there.
There.
And here.
Joe, yes. Got question.
Okay.
So what exactly is the Threadripper Pro?
So the Threadripper Pro is actually AMD's workstation series processors. They are focused on professionals like, you know, heavy workstation applications like maybe 8K video editing or maybe 3D rendering. Or basically applications that are very CPU bound and focus on high core counts. And today with us, we actually have the 3975WX, which is AMD's mid-range offering in the 3000 series of the Threadripper Pro. The 3975WX that we have today is actually based off AMD's Zen 2 architecture of CPUs and it has a core count of 32 and a CPU thread count of 64. Now compared to a consumer grade CPU like the Ryzen 9 5900X that we have right here,
it actually has
a CPU core count of 12 and a thread count of 34.
Wait, that's like at least double, right?
That's actually more than double.
Wow, okay.
Yeah, so you would think the 3975X would be significantly better. But that's what we are here today to actually find out.
Okay.
Because with a cost of about $4,300, you know, is it going to be significantly more expensive?
And we wonder, right? Yeah.
Or is it going to be completely about the same? So more or less, that's what we want to find out. So we'll be breaking out the test into three major segments. But before that, remember to like and subscribe if you want to see more content like this.
That's right.
Or leave a comment down below. I mean, if you don't like Mel and you want her gone, that works too.
What did I do to you?
I'm awesome.
I
Okay, but back to where we were. We're breaking it into three major segments. Firstly, gaming. Secondly, productivity. Like things like, you know, Adobe Premiere Pro. And lastly...
And the last part, which I'm looking forward to.
Which is?
Special test. Secret test.
Yeah. So in this secret test, we will be trying to break the Threadripper Pro. How?
Sounds exciting. Stay tuned. Sounds exciting. Yes.
Back from testing, and you know, surprisingly speaking, some of the results were within expectations, but some of them were actually quite surprising even for me.
Especially that one.
Yeah.
That one. Yeah, that one.
So, why not, let's break down the results and let Mel take over.
Okay.
Bye, I'm out. See you guys.
That's not the plan leh. Hello? Joe?
Okay, so when it came to gaming benchmarks, we actually ran two games, both at 1080p and max presets. So we ran Red Dead Redemption 2 and Shadow of the Tomb Raider. So in this benchmarks itself, for Red Dead Redemption 2, we realized that the Threadripper actually loses to the consumer grade 5900X.
Yes.
For this benchmark and the Tomb Raider, we actually did see similar results, but this was within expectations considering that the 5900X does have better single core performance. So when it comes to gaming, it would seem that the Threadripper Pro isn't exactly in a strong suit.
Yeah.
But when it comes to productivity stress testing, this was the part that was a bit finicky and surprising to know. Because when it came to things like Premiere Pro, where it's supposedly going to be about 20 to 25% better in terms of things like exporting, scrubbing, and even, you know, just rendering the video. Generally, Mel didn't exactly find too much difference.
I didn't see much of a difference, even though I expected it to be some kind of way, yeah? But yeah, there's more to it.
But I mean, from my end, I did see some frame skipping when it was doing scrubbing. But it wasn't something that was very consistent to actually pull up all the time.
Yeah, exactly.
So it was a bit hit and miss. When it comes to exporting, however, the Threadripper Pro is slightly faster. But we honestly don't have enough testing for that regard to really make a conclusion as of right now.
Yes.
But when it comes to different programs, like for example, we ran 7-zip for decompression and compression. In this case, the Threadripper Pro actually destroys the consumer-grade 300X by a significant amount. In fact,
was it like almost double?
Yeah, it was actually double.
It's like double the speed.
About double or even more than double
probably
the speed,
more,
actually.
Yeah, yeah.
But when it comes to, lastly, what else do we run? Yeah, when we ran single-core performance and multi-core performance, the Threadripper Pro actually significantly beat the 300X in multi-core performance. But in single-core performance, however, it actually lost. So in this case, right, we can actually more or less kind of understand that the 3975X, as much as it's a very good CPU for what it's supposed to do in terms of multitasking, when it comes to single-core workloads, right, or even gaming itself, it may not exactly be the best CPU for you.
Yes.
So apart from that, that's more or less the conclusion to our testing. And now we are actually at our last task.
Is it time?
Yeah.
Is it time?
Yeah, it's finally time.
Is it time to break
so
the PC?
So now, we will actually try to break the Threadripper Pro.
Can't wait.
Hey guys, as you can see, it's been quite a while, about 2 to 3 hours to be exact. As you can see, the system is
still running.
Kind of running.
Kind of, yeah.
Kind of not.
Still
know.
Multitasking, get it? Yeah.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah, it's good.
Let's move on.
Yeah, yeah, it's still running, yeah.
As you saw earlier, my colleague John has been trying to crash the system for quite
John.
A while. But, as you can see, here, you know, it's kind of stuck.
We tried.
But at the same time, it's not.
We tried to break the PC, guys.
Who's to say whether it crashed or not? But I hope this was as entertaining and fun as it was for us, as it was for you.
Definitely entertaining for me. I was really looking forward to doing this, but it looks like it's too strong. Yeah, it's too strong.
So, well, today we would like to thank AMD for this opportunity to do a fun project like this.
Yes.
And well, hopefully in the future, we get to do more interesting projects like this.
Looking
Let
forward.
Let us know what you want to see below and what you think this format could be improved or what you would like to see. And apart from that, I would also like to thank Melvallous for spending the whole day with us.
Melvallous.
Close enough. So, you know.
How's that close? Yeah. But seriously though, thank you Invader PC for inviting me over here to be part of this project. You know, trying to break the PC and all that. Really, really enjoy ourselves today. Thank you.
They know it's already. But you know, for you guys who don't know, Invader PC is, we are basically a new boutique PC system, you know?
Yes.
Yeah. It's coming up. So what we plan to do is we want to do things that kind of focus on letting the customer, the consumer, you basically, kind of create a new experience for yourself and not be bounded by your own boundaries, be it, you know, budget price point, space constraints, or anything like that. So currently we're still up and coming. So I mean, throughout the video, you saw some sneak peeks of our showroom and everything. Right now, things are still a bit hectic, but you know, keep a lookout through our socials down below. You know, at the same time, do follow Mel's socials.
Thank you.
You know, because she was a great host. It was fun working with her on projects like this.
Yes.
You know, and don't forget to comment if you don't want her here as well.
Why do you keep saying that? I'm sad, no.
Yeah, you know. Or let us know if you want to see her again.
It's still running.
Kind of.
I think it's...
Yeah. It just changed color.
We're just going to leave it there. Yeah.
So, hope you guys have a nice one. And we'll see you in the next one.
Bye-bye.